Six Galaxies special video. As I said, I would do a video of my collection once the my new setup was complete. And yeah, it's pretty much completed. So without further ado, let's take a look at what I've got. This cabinet here is mostly my Marvel stuff. I'll just zoom in there. So you can see we've got the Wolverine, Odin, the Shatari Commander and Foot Soldier 2-pack, Spider-Man 3, and the Light Asgardian Thor. So yeah, and then we've got Loki in the back there, the Avengers Loki. I did see the new Loki on display at Anime Exchange. It does look quite good, but I'd only get it for the Aether, so spending that much money just for one little item, I could do without him. I've also got my Big Chief Studio stuff in here. I've got the Sherlock Holmes, Dr. John Watson, and the 10th Dr. David Tennant figures. They all come with signed stickers that you stick onto a little plaque that comes with the figure on the display stand. I've just kept the signatures sealed because I've got no intentions of peeling them off. The lighting might be a bit bad in here. But I've got Hawkeye and the Avengers Black Widow. I saw the new Black Widow Winter Soldier on display a couple of days ago. It was behind glass, so I didn't get that much of a good look at her, but she looks alright. Once again, I don't know, the only different accessories, the cell phone, I think. I'll come back to, we've got Captain America, the first Avenger there. Haven't seen a Golden Age up close, but yeah, he was another one I passed on because it was similar. I've got Last Stand, Wolverine, and Nick Fury. I'll come back to those when I'm done with some better lighting. So this is my G.I. Joe stuff that I've got the Mandarin there. I've got Red Skull, Snake Eyes, Storm Shadow, Roadblock. Can't really see her because I've got her on an angle there. I've got Baroness. And I have the Cobra Commander. Yeah, she's the exclusive. She's got the extra portrait. Normally, she'd just have that one. And I've used the background that came with the Mandarin for the background there. Figured I'd just do a Cobra Hydra mashup there, just because thought it'd be kind of cool to do that. And then I've got the Hulk, Patriot, Mark 7, Banner, and the Workshop Stark. I'll just go back over them with the better lighting, like I said I'd do. So that's the not the 2-pack. The Hulk was the original release. Yeah, Hulk was the original release, and Banner I just picked up separately. And yeah, I've got Workshop Tony. Patriot and 7. Mark 7's not exclusive. There you can see Roadblock. You can see Roadblock a lot better. And if I come up to this one, yeah, I probably should invest in some LED lighting or something for these cabinets, but just with all the figures lately, I've just been trying to get all those, not really worrying about the displays. So yeah, there's Last Stand Wolverine, and there's Coulson and Fury, which I'm quite surprised Coulson might be a bit more popular now. I don't want to give it the spoiler. If you watch Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you'll know what I'm talking about. Maybe we'll see him in Avengers 2, I'm not too sure. Alright, next display. So I've just got a random German from the Hasbro Indiana Jones line. I think it's Hasbro there, but I've got my shiny and veteran deluxe clone. I've got my Phase 1 clone, my Sarge, Captain, and Commander, and there I've got a Hasbro Admiral there. It's pretty cool for a Hasbro figure. I never had any issues with him. There is a gap there because I normally put my custom Kitbash there, but I'm just doing a bit of work on her. So she's not there at the moment. Now, probably one of the worst things to try and see in the photos are the Shadow Troopers, because in my older photos I've got them towards the back and they literally blended into the back wall and so you couldn't see them. But I've got two Shadow Troopers, Thrawn, Bakara, Wolf, and Snowtrooper. When I get the Wolf Pack Trooper, hopefully he still ships out in November, I'll move Wolf out and have them side by side. I've got Harley Quinn, Joker 2.0, the DX, DXL11 I think it is. I've got Scarecrow, I've still got Bat Demon but he's in the box, Harvey Dent, and Bane. So yeah, I do collect a fair few lines. I mostly started with the Star Wars, but then when Hot Toys became widely available, I started picking up those. Now this one here is just stuff by chance that I've managed to grab at decent prices. I've got the Enter Bay J&K. You can't really see him, but Frank is at the back there. I've got the Sideshow exclusive versions. I do not have the actual boxes for these because I purchased them secondhand, but I've got the Sideshow exclusive Mulder, Scully, and Daggett, and that's the 007 Pierce Brosnan. The reason you know that they're Sideshow exclusive, it's because they had different outfits on to the regular releases, and they've got the FBI jackets. The FBI jackets with the Sideshow exclusive, and Daggett's in a suit where the standard release had him in SWAT gear. And I've also, don't know what company makes them, but I've got a couple of those little aliens. I've bought them for like $1 at a garage sale. So I thought, yeah, X-Files, that'd be pretty cool. So yeah, I put them there with the I Wanna Believe poster that come from Mulder. If you've seen my pictures, then you know that I have a lot of clone troopers. I've got every single clone trooper actually, to date, but I've got, that's the original Unterpar 212. The Air Trooper, Airborne Trooper, is behind him. I've got Cody with the holdout Palpatine. Numa, it's the exclusive Numa. The standard release, she doesn't come with the arm holding the toy. There's the Deluxe 212, and there's Wax and Boyle. Waxer and Boyle. I don't think. And then I've got the, this is the Sideshow exclusive version. I haven't got the display stand, that's exclusive out, but it's the original Anakin. I really like the eyes on this one. It's the Darth Vader, it was a Comic Con. Now, the only thing I don't like about this figure is, in, as you can see there, it flakes. This one's just started doing it recently. I've got two of the original Anakins, the Jedi Anakin, and they flake way worse than this one. I keep them in the boxes. And I've got Neo, 41st Corp, Gree. This guy's a Metacom trooper, so you can see he's a bit shorter than all the rest. It's probably only complaint about Metacom stuff that they're shorter than others. I've of course got Bly, and I've got the Siege Trooper behind him. I've got the old Lord of the Rings stuff. So I've got Gandalf, Aragorn, Boromir, Frodo and Sam, Faramir, and Legolas. The I like the Imus stuff that's coming out. It looks quite good. I haven't picked up Gandalf the White yet, although I'd like to. I think the only place I've seen him available so far is Big Bad Toy Store. Yeah. Just light the shelf up a bit better. I have got the Modal Node Band, the all five. Two of them were Comic-Con exclusive. Two of them were Sideshow Store exclusive, which meant you had to find a retailer that sold them. Ours was Pop. Pop Culture. I don't know if they've still got any, but they were ours. They took them to Supernova 1 year. And I've got the Captain Harlock Throne of Arcadia there with Mr. Bird. He's fallen down. Probably my fault for trying to have him sitting on his arm all the time, but yeah, alright, next display. So yeah, as we saw in the previous Dear Toff, we had the 212. Like I said, the 501st go real well with the 212. So I've got the standard 501st Trooper, the exclusive with the white base. Got the Deluxe 501st Trooper. Just move in there a bit closer. So as you can see, the Deluxe, we talked about this on the forum, on the page, when they first came out. This guy is more of a clean, we're going to attack the Jedi Temple, completely unopposed Dub Trooper. This guy is more of a veteran, he's a lot grittier, a lot dirtier. There's his Phase 1 helmet. I've got the exclusive Captain Rex with the Phase 2 I'm looking forward to in January. His the new head sculpt is a lot older, as you should be, because it's from Season 5. And this one, this guy's from Season 1. Now I've got Echo from the Echo and Fives 2-pack. There's Fives, and just behind there we have the Lieutenant from Comic-Con a few years back. And down here we have an absolute grail piece of mine, the Stormtrooper Commander. took me a very long time to get this, if you watched the review I did of him. We have the standard white Stormtrooper. The original Shock Trooper release. Hopefully they do a deluxe Shocky or something. They weren't really in Clone Wars all that much, but a 2.0 would be nice. We've got Pradgy, Commander Fox, Piat, another Hasbro Admiral, and the fellow in the back there, if you're unaware, Sideshow had a couple of, Sideshow, when they used to do their Comic Con exclusives, they did a Celebration exclusive for the convention. I think it was Germany that year. And this guy's Commander Gantch. So he's a comic book clone trooper, but looks really cool. And I was happy to be able to pick him up when Sideshow said, well, if you can't attend, we have a non-attendee edition. It was the exact same trooper, just without the convention sticker. Okay. So down here we have my Hot Toys blade. I haven't taken any of the accessories out of the box, just him and the sunglasses. He's very nice figure. I've got the Asmus Morgulord there. I haven't done it yet because I'm not 100% sure. Depending on all the Star Wars coming out, if I'll grab her or not. But apparently the Arrowen release. It's coming with a new body for him. I'm not sure how he's supposed to take the robes and stuff off. But hopefully that's going to be explained in the instructions when she comes out. Have the Metacom Severus Snape. The New Blood Jason Voorhees from Sideshow. It's quite an old figure. And I've got the Nightmare on Elm Street 1 Freddy Krueger, which is also quite an old figure. And in behind the back there, I've got the Asmus Goth Mog. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure I'm picking up any more of the Asmus stuff. Like I said, it's not bad, but I've got, and you'll see these soon. Oh, I already showed you other. I've got the Sideshow Gandalf there. The Gandalf the White from Asmus looks good, but probably have to pass on that one. Arrowen would be tempting though. And down here I have a few of my Transformers. I've got the Dark of the Moon Bumblebee, the Takara Optimus, the Takara Grimlock, Beast Wars Megatron, and the Takara Soundwave. I've also got the additional cassettes in the boxes. I figured I shouldn't remove them. And you can't really see them, can't really see him because of Optimus. But I've got the Sideshow many years ago did a Six Gun Legends line. I've got the Cantina environment just because I didn't have enough room for it where I originally had it, but I've got the six gun legend wide up. See, this guy, I think he's quite rare now. I picked him up for a bargain. I think there was an eBay auction for about, I think it was 15 Sideshow figures, and it was a real cheap bulk lot. So yeah, I've just got in there, and I've got Billy the Kid behind Optimus there as well. Yeah, I don't really collect any of the other historical stuff. I'll show you the other figures that came in the set. I was actually buying another one. It was just by chance that he was in the set. So I knew that it was quite worth it, because I think I see him for about $2.99 now, because a lot of Americans love their historical figures. I've got just that empty cabinet here. That's probably where I'm going to put a lot of this year's releases. Definitely the, like I said, I'll probably move out a couple of the troops, maybe put Wolf and the Wolfpack Trooper here. And I know that we've got like the Ordnance Bomb Trooper coming out. So yeah, probably the Hoff, Han, Hoff Luke, Falcon, Bucky, Winter Soldier. So yeah, I'll just move on to the next. Sorry for the reflective glare. I'll just open it, see if it makes it any better. But so I've got a variety of the FX lightsabers. Got a New Hope Kenobis, Mace Windus, Yodas, and Vaders. Some of them, and I've also got Darth Mauls. The blades for Darth Mauls are still in the box because it's way too long to put the blades in. But and it does have the little ring there. Just unscrew it and it comes apart. So you can, there's a little feature in the box that makes it battle damaged as well. So you can just have the one half. You can also have one half ignited, one half turned off. So a lot of display options there. Just a couple of the new Funko Back to the Future figures. I've got my Arkham Origins Collector's Edition. I've got a boxed. I've got a boxed Comic-Con holographic Sidious from a few years ago. Got a couple of Marty mugs, a few mugs. I've got a Corgi DeLorean. Don't know how well it's going to show up, but it's actually signed by Christopher Lloyd. And thank you to Anime Exchange for the Bayonetta gun. I had it for ages, but a housemate broke my original collector's edition one, and they were able to sell me one for a very fair price, so thank you for that. And I've also got the Power of the Jedi AT-ST. I have got a lot more Hasbro carded figures, but they're all packed away due to space. I've got a boxed X-Wing Watchdogs Collector Edition, and I've got a couple of the older Hasbro 12 inches box as well. Got the Leia and the Luke. There's also a TC-14 and a few others. So yeah, I've got my loose Hasbros. Had to pack a lot of them away. I've got a fair few Hasbro guys. I've got Tarpus. I do have the Caddo still boxed. I just took the Tarpus out because I thought it looked good for a Hasbro figure. I've got the Chewbacca with the chain. Sorry for the lighting. This room has a lot of curtains around it to stop sun damage. I've got TC-14. I also have, like I said, I've got another TC-14, just boxed. Don't think the batteries. No, the batteries in him have died. But I've got. You can't really see him. I've got a weathered 3PO.
I am C-3PO.
He still works. I've got a clean and weathered R2. The weathered R2 used to. Oh, yeah, the batteries have gone in him too. But I've got, R5 before. Hasbro Tarkin. I've got a loose Sideshow Bespin Luke. I only paid like $30 for him, so it was alright for what it was. And it came with a, I'm not sure what Sideshow sculpt this is, but it came with that sculpt as well. I know that the Luke didn't come with more than one sculpt, so it's interesting. He doesn't have all these accessories either, but like I said, for loose $30 for a Sideshow figure, I can't complain. I've got Hasbro Dooku and the droids. I've got the two bikes. I just put the pilot on there because I liked it in Battlefront, how the snow troopers, snow pilots had the bikes, so that's cool. And I've got two Hasbro snow troopers. One's a bit sun damaged. That's how I got him. He wasn't very expensive because of that. I keep my Man of Steel Blu-ray down here. And apologies for the light. So there's Jor-El, a vintage Boba Fett 12-inch. The Man of Steel, Superman, Zod. I've got a Batman statue there. I'm getting the armory when it's released in Australia with Alfred and Wayne. So I'm gonna try and fit it in here somehow. Got the X-12. I've got the statue from the Injustice Collectors. I've got Selena Kyle sitting on the Batpod there. I've got the DC. They're a little bit taller than a normal 1/6 scale figure. I think they're 13 inches. But I've got DC Direct, Rorschach, and Batgirl. And I've also got the Toy Fair exclusive SWAT Gordon. So I'm quite excited about the new Gordon coming out with the Bat Signal and all that. And Blake. And we've got a few pop vinyls, Game of Thrones. Just some more boxed Hasbro. I've got the Anakin Skywalker book. I've also got the Aura Sing book. And a very old remote control. You put it on a string and it spins around. X-Wing, I've never tried it. It's just sealed in the box. And I've got the old Galactic Hero line, which was cancelled. And that's just the box for the Deluxe Vader. I've got the Star Wars. These guys here I haven't had a chance to pack back in anyway yet. But yeah, there's my Boss Nurse, the Hasbro Django, and sealed Tusken Raider, and the entire Star Wars shop exclusive from a very long time ago. Cantina Band 12 inches. So I was Bib Fortuna and Luke Skywalker, Jedi Knight, Hasbro, and the Hasbro Valorum with the blue Senate Guard. So I'll just move on to the next display. So this is the bottom shelf, so it's a bit darker than all the others because there's a couch that's blocking it so it doesn't get too sun damaged because of where the door is. But I've got the Sand Trooper. It's not the exclusive with the extra hand, the golden droid piece, but it's pretty cool. I've got the Sand Trooper Deluxe, the Probe Droid, which made a video of. At the back there, I've got a couple of more Hasbro Troopers, Hasbro Clone Troopers. I've got the Sideshow Jubak, the original Hot Toys Predator kit from ABP2. It's starting to degrade a bit, so I don't really mess around with him anymore. But yeah, he's just becoming way too fragile. And his pads just slide straight down now, so. Just goes to show what happens with age. I've got the other two sand troopers, the corporal and the squad leader. I need to dust these up sometime too. Got Hasbro Mouse Droid, Hasbro Biker Scout, the Hasbro Jubak. Got a couple of custom painted clone troops there. I've got the green one and the black one. And Grindon, clone trooper, and just a custom creature there. And the little droid that follows them. Yeah. Like I said, I'm a huge fan of the troopers. So try and get all of them. So far I have all of them. I know that the sand troopers are quite expensive nowadays, so I was glad picked them up when they were standard Sideshow price. Next cabinet is shelf darker again. So I've got the exclusive Han Solo poster there that come with a Greedo. Greedo is just there. We've got the Hasbro Zuckus, Hasbro Gamorrean, the two different Gamorreans. I've got the wall environment there with the little creatures from the pack. Hasbro Pit Droid, Hasbro Jawas, the second table and chair set, Hammerhead, a modern Nemo, I think it's pronounced. So he's just trying to slide the doors, stop the reflective light. Put the Han Solo carbonate piece with the other creatures up there. Boba Fett. I do have a Metacom Django, but he, I packed him away. The Hasbro Zam Wessel. Jabba. I've got the Clone Wars Anakin boxed, but this is the exclusive, I think it's Rodder from the Clone Wars movie. So he was a really cool exclusive to get. The Sideshow exclusive Tusken Raider, the Hasbro Tusken Raider, Hasbro and Sideshow IG-88, Hasbro Greedo, Hasbro Chewbacca, without the belt, Bib Fortuna there. Yeah, I've got the current Scum and Villainy line by Sideshow, just haven't gotten the throne, but as you can probably see, I've got no room for it anyway, so as much as in the Sideshow Bosque there. As nice as it is to have, I've got no room for it. Alright, next display. I'll just say, just at the top here, I've got they're all put, stacked back as well. The news agency did the Ships of Star Wars line a couple years back. I've got most of those. I don't know if I ever completed the full set or not, but just thought I'd show you those. And I've got a set of Dragon Balls from Bandai and the collector's edition of Skyrim, the All the Wind statue. So coming over here, I've got the Hot Toys Luke on the weather vane. I didn't really have this piece out, but I had a spot for it, so I put it out. Probably pack it away soonish. I've got the Sideshow. This is the exclusive Kenobi. There is a holographic Leia sitting, I think, over with the clone troopers. Just the holographic Leia is what made this exclusive. There is one of my favourites. And there's the mentor Yoda from Empire. I've got the newer Yoda, but I packed him back up when I rearranged. Yeah, you get a lot with the house. You get the cooking set, the plates, the stools. The lightsaber that she's holding is obviously from the new Yoda. And then there's a little magnetic dragon thing. And there's a few snakes around the place as well. Which is fitting because the snake was the exclusive. So in this one I've got my three Hasbro Royal Guards and the exclusive Palpatine. There's the sculpt that makes it the exclusive. And the throne. I've got Malgus. I've got the Metacom Trooper. Maul. The Deluxe Vader. Like I said, I've got the normal Vader. He's packed away though. And this guy at the back here, and I'll show you by moving the helmet. He's just a marmot kit. So he's pretty good. Looks pretty good for an old vinyl kit. Here I've got my droids. If you saw the recent battle droid review I did, I've got another Comic Con Darth Sidious. I was sold one and the base part was broken. The seller reckons there was no way it could be broken, but it was. It had been glued together really poorly, and so when you sat him on there, it just collapsed. There's the exclusive Ventress with the two sculpts. We've got the rusted droids. We have the plain white droids, and we've got OOM-9. It being during the day, if you watched my review, the yellow on OOM-9's head didn't show up, but you can see the yellow spots really good now with the lighting. And then I've got the Sith probe droids. And then Grievous at the back there. Two spots there. Probably put more of the newer Star Wars figures in there. I was just trying to leave space open. And then my final display. We've got the Jedi. So I've got Qui-Gon, the Comic-Con, Ella Secura, Cat Fisto, Kyo De Mundi, Mace Windu, the exclusive Kenobi, because he's got Captain Rex on his shoulder there. Plo Koon. And I've also got Metacom Wicket. Hopefully Sideshow do their own, more articulated. So here, I've got the Hasbro Chewbacca, the Hot Toys Luke, the other Luke, comes in a 2-pack. The original Sideshow Han, it's the exclusive version with the second blaster. Got Leia. The older Ilum Padme. I picked her up quite cheap, so I wasn't fussed that it's not the best figure ever. And it's the Bandai Metal 3PO. So yeah, probably can't hear the metal because of the glass shelving. And I've got the Sideshow Lando as well. So yeah, a few oldies, a couple of more recents, and I've got the Rebel Troops. So I've got the Pathfinder, I believe his name's Nick Saint, the Commando and just the Infantry Trooper, and then I've got the Blockade Runner Trooper. Just fix his helmet up. He's the this guy was sculpted to be the guy that first looks up at the door before the Stormtroopers come in A New Hope. And I've got Captain Antilles, Blockade Runner Gear 2. And what you didn't see in my Battle Droid review, I've got the two Staps and the Security Droids. So I'll just pan back over that because I went quite fast. Yeah, don't know if I'll do more Rebel Troops or whatever, maybe a Hoth Trooper with the new Hoth versions of Rebels that are coming out. So yeah, I'll just show you a couple more things before. So yeah, this here is my stack of mint in-box figures. They're not sealed or anything, but just briefly I'll go over some of the ones that I can get to. So I've got the Hot Toys Sweeney Todd, the Emperor Insidious 2-pack, That one there is the Metacom Django. A couple of Lego. That's just the box for the Planet of the Apes figure. Like I said, I've got that set. That was real cheap. I've got the Reservoir Dogs, Hogan's Heroes, Brian and Mandy. I've also got Shaun and Ed from Shaun of the Dead. There's a second New Nightmare. They're the Hot Toys 66 Batman and Robin. Scarecrow, I mean, this was the box for Scarecrow and Bat-Demon. Bat-Demon's still inside the box. Scarecrow I've got out. This one here is the original Sideshow Vita. This one here is the Christmas Yoda. You open him up and he's Santa Yoda. I've also got a Sean Connery 007 in the white suit behind there. And there's Get Smart and the Chief. So yeah, I bought like all the random ones like Get Smart, Reservoir Dogs, Life of Brian, Shaun of the Dead. There was a pack of, there was 15 or so with Wyatt Earp and Billy Kid. The auction, I was so surprised. It was like 15 figures for like $200 or something. It was crazy. I've also got the Farm Boy Luke in the, you can't really see. There's the Obi-Wan Kenobi and Farm Boy Luke. I've also got a few monsters figures there. There's this one here is Christopher Lee as Dracula. There's also the exclusive Stormtrooper Luke and Han from many Comic Cons ago. And this one here is War Machine Mark One. It's got slight battery leakage, but that wasn't my fault. Because when I bought it, it was just mint in box, and I didn't know that it was mint in sealed box. Seller failed to mention that, so it's alright, it still works. It just looks a bit bad. We've got the 89 Batmobile. I've also got the Tumbler stored away as well. Yeah, I've also got, like I said, I've got the two Jedi Anakins, and I've got the Clone Wars Anakin. As well, they're in a different place because I actually keep, so like all my boxes, you can see my Hasbro stuff there as well. It's been a bit messy since the flood. You can see the box for some of the Sand Troopers, exclusive Tot, Bubba. It's my Optimus box, vintage AT-AT there. The box for SWAT Gordon. It's got the Sideshow sticker there. It's all my boxes. Keep them in here. I've got a lot more boxes upstairs too. I'll probably pan over. I'll probably pan over it to conclude the video. But yeah, thanks for tuning in, guys. And I hope you enjoy my collection. I'll just say as well, I've got an exclusive Indiana Jones 4. Inside the white box here is the fridge. It's all burnt out. And there's the Yoda there. I'll just say I did say that when I have my clone troopers there is a little gap. I've been working on fixing up the shirt. But there's my custom Jedi at the moment. Just got the clone gear on. The shirt, as you can see, the shirt's way too big. I've had a lot of suggestions about fixing it. Thanks, guys. I just haven't had the time with work and uni stuff. But I've got a solution. I think if I unpick the sewing on the sleeves, I'll be able to fold it back and then just pin it. So, that'd be good. And I just need to straighten it out because normally you wouldn't see the red there. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll pan a few more of my boxes at the end.